Hey guys, what's up and welcome back to the channel. So in today's video, we are here with my friends i20. This is the Magna, this is like the starting line of the i20. And the reason I'm making this video is because this, as the name in the title suggests, this is the 1.4 liter engine. This car has been discontinued by i20 back in 2017, and my friend bought this car in 2018, in December of 2018, and he got a pretty sweet deal on it. This was one of the cars that was lying in the showroom for some time, and he had a contact in the Hyundai, and he managed to get this car for a pretty sweet deal. Now the problem with this car is that this car is a 1.4 liter engine and it comes with the 4-speed gearbox. We'll sit in the car and have a little round of this car and show you all that this gearbox is a 4-speed, and the problem with this 4-speed and the problem with this 1.4 liter engine. Now what happened is, back in 2017, Hyundai was trying to get an automatic series for its 1.2 liter engine, which was not compatible, and as a result what they did is they got the Eurospec 1.4 liter engine into the Indian market, and this being a more powerful engine could be attached to the 4-speed automatic gearbox. Now this is the same automatic gearbox that you get in the old i10. It has a 4-speed gearbox, and the problem with this is that although it's an automatic gearbox, it's only a 4-speed gearbox, and the engine is a bigger engine and the gearbox is a 4-speed, the mileage is completely terrible. Now Hyundai, the dash does not display the mileage, and even in the later models the dash do not display the mileage, and as a result of that you don't know exactly how much you're getting. But what we know for sure is that if you couple a 1.4 liter engine that gives out 98 brake horsepower, 100 PS of power, and has 135 Newton meters of torque, coupled with a 4-speed gearbox, it's going to give some really bad average in that sense. And that's why Hyundai had to discontinue the 1.4 liter engine from its series and only keep the 1.2 liter engine. And now finally they have managed to get the 1.2 liter engine with a 6-speed automatic gearbox, which makes more sense because you will need to have more higher gear ratios to get better average. So guys, this being the base level, the automatic gearbox in 2017 was only available on the base level, and the price was more than 10 lakhs. So now what was happening is that this car is a base level, so you do not get the infotainment system, which is the Hyundai infotainment system. You have to put this aftermarket one like my friend has done in his car. You also don't get those many gadgets. For example, a lot of things are missed out, like the amount of tech that's there on the steering wheel, a lot of things are missed out as a result of that. And we don't have the projector headlamps, the DRLs, they're all gone. And in fact, even this model, which I'll show you from outside, has the standard wheels. It does not have the alloy wheels that you get with the top model. So what happened is that you are paying for the top model value, but that's only because you're putting a 1.4 liter engine, which is more expensive, in the front, and you're getting a gearbox with a 4-speed gearbox. So in the end, the people who are buying this car who wanted an automatic 1.2 liter engine or somewhere around automatic hatchback were turning away from Hyundai as a result, and were not opting for this 4-speed because this 4-speed will eventually give you a very poor average. And as a result, you don't even have a top spec, because the automatic gearbox on the 1.4 liter engine was not available on the top specs. It's only available on the base variant. So that was another negative thing. Now we just go for a little drive and show you all that this car is very comfortable to drive, no doubt. But what happens as a result of that is that right now, while it's cruising, it feels really good. The gear shifts are not bad. Even if I go into sports mode, I'm still on the first gear. I even at around 20 kilometers per hour, and at around 28 shifts RPMs, and goes to the second gear. And this car has Shiptonic, so you can go into the manual mode and go plus minus, but it's not that refined and it's not that responsive, the Triptonics, I must say. It's not that spontaneous, but otherwise the car is a pretty good car. I'm really glad that Hyundai has decided to put the 6-speed automatic gearbox on the 1.2 liter engine. And even when it's on Triptonics, the car does have a mind of its own and it does gear shift. It does not give you full control. So once put on Triptonics, you can shift at higher RPMs. It really does help, and you get a nice boost out of it. So guys, another thing about this car is that since this car was a 2017 model and my friend bought it in December of 2018, that means it's more than a year old. It was just sitting in the warehouse and they had this product they wanted to use. My friend got a pretty sweet deal on it, like I said, and I'm not going to tell you what the deal was, how much he got. But so basically this car, the on-road price was around 10.6 lakhs, and because it's the automatic variant, and he managed to get this car at Hyundai for a very sweet deal. He just got it for 8.4 lakhs. So if you go to see, that's more than 2 lakhs less he got, managed to get this car. Obviously, it was an old car. The car was not the facelift model. The facelift had already come by then. And he got this car much more than a 2 lakh discount. So that was the advantage of buying this car. So you might also be able to go to Hyundai and see if they have some old inventory with them, which can be moved out, which are they looking to move out for lower values. Hyundai usually has a lot of these cars which are manufactured and kept and are yet to be moved out, and that's how you can get a better deal. So if you are into that and you are okay with having an older version, consider a Hyundai. You could also find some car for a lesser value which is lying in their warehouse. So guys, yeah, that wraps up this video to show that we had this 1.4 liter engine by i20 and Hyundai, and they discontinued this variant. So I was really glad about the 1.4 liter engine, in that sense that this 1.4 liter engine was a more powerful engine, produced quite a lot more brake horsepower in comparison to the regular i20, which produces only 83 brake horsepower. This 98 or 100 PS car has more power, and that is fun to drive and exciting to drive, but at the same time it was only available with this very poor 4-speed automatic gearbox. Now don't get me wrong, this 4-speed automatic gearbox is good, it's responsive, but then again it has a mind of its own. Sometimes it shifts at low RPM, so you don't feel any jhatkas or jerks that way. So it's a refined automatic gearbox. It's not the CVT, but it's an automatic gearbox. Right now the i20 that we have in 2020, it comes with a CVT gearbox, so that's a more rubbery effect, but that's 6-speed, so the mileage will be better on that as compared to what you would get in this. In this car the mileage is not displayed, and I can ask my friend to try to do a proper manual calculation and tell you how much the mileage is coming, but the mileage in overall what you could expect in city driving could be as less as say 8 or even less than that. So that's what you can expect with a more powerful engine and a very poor gearbox. Then again, in the i10 Grand we have the 1.2 liter engine, which was a less powerful engine as compared to the one in the i20, and that again had the 4-speed gearbox, and that again people were complaining about the poor average that car was giving as well. So anyway guys, that's what I had to say about this 1.4 liter engine, this Magna engine that my friend has. It's a very good engine, but not a good gearbox, and as a result i20 now has redone its engine and created a new engine which is compatible with a 6-speed automatic gearbox, the CVT gearbox, and it is a 1.2 liter engine. It's the regular 1.2 liter engine that you get in your manual cars as well. Anyway guys, that wraps up this video. If you all did like this video, please hit the like, subscribe, share button, and remember you guys can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter, and also on DriveTribe where we publish some literature content, and I hope to see you in the next one. Cheers.